The image that you are watching on your screen is the first ever direct image of a black hole. This image is being considered as one of the greatest discoveries of recent times, as this image has accomplished what was considered impossible almost 250 years ago. But not all of you know that what motivated scientists to capture this image was another landmark image. And that image was of Cygnus X1, the first ever black hole discovered by humankind. This image proved that black holes do exist, and this image was taken with the help of the Chandra X-ray telescope. This legendary telescope was named after a legendary scientist named Subrahmanyan Chandrasekhar. But why was this telescope named after an Indian scientist? Let's find out. Subrahmanyan Chandrasekhar was a Nobel Prize winning astrophysicist and fellow of the Royal Society. He was born in Lahore, then a part of India, in 1910 in a Tamil Hindu family. His father was a deputy auditor general of the Northwestern Railways and brother of none other than C.V. Raman, who was also a Nobel Prize winning physicist, fellow of the Royal Society and a Bharat Ratna. He went to the Hindu High School in Chennai, then Madras, and later at the age of 14 went to study physics at the Presidency College in Chennai. At the tender age of 19, he graduated with a BSc Honours degree in physics. He then decided to move to United Kingdom after getting a scholarship to study for a PhD degree at the University of Cambridge. While less ordinary people usually enjoy a long journey, Chandrasekhar decided to utilize his travel time from Chennai to London in reviewing the physics behind collapsing stars. And by the time he reached London, he developed a theoretical model explaining the physics behind collapsing stars. In his theory, when a star weighing less than 1.4 times the mass of our sun dies, it turns into a white dwarf. While a dying star having a mass greater than 1.4 times the mass of our sun will form a neutron star or a black hole with a central singularity of infinite density. This limit came to be known as the Chandrasekhar limit. Frustrated by the lack of acceptance at Cambridge for his theory, he moved to the United States as a research associate at the University of Chicago after his fellowship ended. He remained affiliated with the Chicago University for the rest of his life. He received the Padma Vibhushan in 1968, which is India's second highest civilian honor, instead of the Bharat Ratna, which is India's highest civilian honor, a title which he truly deserves. Apart from Chandrasekhar limit, Chandrasekhar number, which is a dimensionless number, asteroid 1958 Chandra, the Chandra X-ray telescope, and the Himalayan Chandra telescope, which is situated in Hanle in Ladakh in India, are all named after him. All these groundbreaking theories of his compelled us to include him in our list of super Indians. Share this video to spread the word, and let's hope that one day he gets awarded the Bharat Ratna. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Do check out our other videos as well. Links to a few are on your screen. Please subscribe and do not forget to hit the like button. See you in another video. Thanks for watching.